Thank you for the invitation. I'm Aurélien Vasseur. I'm a PhD student in Telecom Paris Tech, under the supervision of Laurent de Grosfond from Telecom Paris Tech and Frédéric Chazal from the INRIA of Saclay. And this presentation, entitled Asymptotics of Some Pwn Processes Transformations, aims to expose some recent works done with Laurent de Grosfond. So the primary motivation of this work was the following. If we consider the locations of the base stations of the mobile network in Paris, and if we have a look at the global process of all the base stations for all operators and all frequency bands, we get the left picture. It turns to be compatible with a Poisson Pwn process. However, if we look at the process of the base stations for only one operator, for one frequency band, we get the right picture. And it was recently shown that it is statistically compatible with a Pwn process with repulsion called Ginibre Pwn process. Then it seems that when we superpose a large number of Pwn processes like this, we tend to obtain a Poisson Pwn process. So we have to, the aim of the work is to precise this convergence. So in a first part, after giving some basic definitions and properties on Pwn processes, we propose a precise definition for repulsiveness on Pwn processes. In this work, the Pwn processes which are repulsive of reference are detrimental Pwn processes, and we give a short description of them. Then, in the second part, we define a convergence on Pwn processes. It is defined by a distance called the Kantorovich-Rubinstein distance, and we can show that when we take this distance between a finite Poisson Pwn process and another finite Pwn process, we have a nice upper bound. So we will be able to show the convergence of some sequences of Pwn processes defined by several transformations. These are applications in the third part. So the operations on Pwn processes that we use are superposition, thinning, and rescaling. So let's begin with a framework. So Y will be a locally compact metric space under with diffuse and locally finite measure mu on Y. NY design the space of configurations on Y. So a configuration is a locally finite subset of Y. And N at Y design the space of finite configurations on Y. Now if phi is a Pwn process, we can describe phi with the two following functions, which are correlation function and Papangelou intensity. So the correlation function rho is a function from n at y to r, and is defined by the first equation, where the test function f is a positive and measurable function from n at y to r. Intuitively, if alpha is a finite configuration of y, rho of alpha represents the probability of finding a particle in at least each point of alpha. So in each point of alpha, and maybe in other locations. The Papangelou intensity C is an application from y times ny to r, and is defined by the second equation, where the test function f is from y times ny to r. And we have also an intuitive explanation. If x is a point of y, and if xi is a configuration of y, c of x xi represents the conditional probability of finding a particle in the location x given the configuration xi. We get immediately the following properties on the Pwn process phi. So the intensity measure is given with help from the correlation function. We can also make a link between the correlation function rho and the Papangeli intensity C. And in the case where phi is a finite point process, we have the following equation obtained with help from the Papangeli intensity definition in the previous slide. For Poisson point processes, we have easy expressions for correlation function and Papangeli intensity. The correlation function of the Poisson point process is depends as an expression which depends only on the intensity measure of the Poisson point process. And we can note that the Papangeli intensity taken for x in x an element and y and xc and a configuration doesn't depend on xc, and we find the idea that in a Poisson point process the probability of finding a point in a given location doesn't depend on the other points of the realization. With help from Papangeli intensity, we propose a definition for repulsiveness. We will say that a point process is repulsive as soon as its Papangeli intensity C verifies the first assertion, and we'll say that it is weakly repulsive if it only satisfies the second assertion. Determinantal point processes are repulsive point processes. To define a determinantal point process, we need a functional operator K with kernel, also called K, so big K, and is defined by its correlation function, rho. So rho is of x1, xk, is the determinant of a k times k matrix, where little k is the size of the configuration x1, xk. And an interesting thing is that we have an explicit expression for Papangeli intensity with help from an operator J associated to k when it's possible, with kernel also called J. And this makes that the determinantal point process is a repulsive point process according to the previous definition. An example of determinantal point process is, in the introduction, the Ginibre point process. So the Ginibre point process is a determinantal point process on the complex space C. Here we consider the Ginibre point process reduced to the ball of center zero and radius R, and its kernel K is given by this first equality. Now, if beta is a real number between zero and one, the beta Ginibre point process is obtained by combining on Ginibre point process two operations, a thinning with parameter beta, and a rescaling of parameter square root of beta, such that we keep the same intensity as the Ginibre point process, which is 1 over p. And we get, if we reduce it to the ball of center 0 and radius r, we get the following kernel for the beta Ginibre point process. We can see some realizations of beta Ginibre point process for several values of beta. So we can see that when beta becomes weaker, we have less and less repulsion between the points. And we can think that when beta tends to zero, the beta Ginibre point process will converge to a point process without repulsion, that is a Poisson point process, like in the figure A. Now we will define the convergence that we will use. So the convergence used on point processes is defined by a distance called Kantorovich-Rubinstein distance. So to build this distance, we need to consider total variation distance. So the total variation distance between two measures, nu1 and nu2, is defined by the following expression. So the supremum is taken for a Borel finite set subset of y. then we can define what is a one Lipschitz function. So an example of one Lipschitz function according to total variation distance is in the following situation. If A is a compact subset of Y, and if we consider the function which for all configuration associates the number of points which fall in A, so f of phi equals phi of A, we have an example of one Lipschitz function. And now the contour of each Lipschitz distance between two point processes P1 and P2 is defined as the supremum for f one Lipschitz of the following expression. So we have a distance on point processes, we have a convergence, and we can precise that this convergence is quite strong because it is strictly finer than the convergence law for point processes. And we have the following results. When phi is a finite point process on Y with Papangelou intensity C, and when zeta m is a Poisson point process with intensity m, we have the following upper bound between for the distance between these two processes. And the upper bound is quite simple because it only depends on two elements, the Papangelou intensity C of the finite point process phi and the intensity measure of the Poisson point process. So we can now apply this to show the convergence of some sequences of point processes to Poisson point process. The first application is about superposition. So we consider for all integer n, phi n1, phi nn, n independent finite and weakly repulsive point processes on Y. Phi n designs their superposition. And if we want to suppose that n tends to infinity, we have also to suppose that the intensity measure of each point process of the superposition tends to zero. We have also to suppose that that the intensity measure of the superposition tends to a given intensity measure that we call m. So here Rn represents the distance between the intensity measure of the superposition and the intensity measure of the Poisson point process, zeta m. And we will suppose that Rn tends to zero. So under these assumptions, we have the following results. The distance between the superposition and the Poisson point process, zeta m, is controlled by sum, where Rn tends to zero, if we suppose it, and the second term tends to zero as soon as the intensity measure of the point process of the superposition tends uniformly to zero. The consequence of this result is given by the following situation. If we draw independently n random variables on 0, 1, according to probability density function f, such that we have a right limit in 0. If we do, so we have n points on 0, 1, we do a rescaling with parameter n. So we have now n points on 0, n, x1, xn. And we consider the xi, which fall in a given compact subset lambda. So phi n is this point process. And we have the convergence of phi n to the Poisson point process with intensity f of 0 plus reduced to lambda, with convergence speed given by the right member of the inequation. So the second application is about beta Geniebre point processes. So for all n, beta n is a real number between 0 and 1. Phi n designs the beta n Geniebre that we reduce to a compact, the same compact subset lambda. And we suppose that beta n tends to 0. And then we have the convergence in contour of each Lipschitz distance of the sequence phi n to the Poisson point process with intensity 1 over p, with convergence speed directly given by beta n. So here c is a constant, and we have the convergence. And actually, we can give a more general result, but for a weaker convergence. This is Kallenberg's theorem. It says that for phi n finite point process on Y for any n, if Pn is a sequence of functions from Y to Z1 which converges uniformly to zero, if we call phi prime n the Pn thinning of phi n, and if gamma m is a Cox process, so Cox process is that is m is a random measure, and conditionally to m, gamma m is a Poisson point process with intensity measure m, then we have the following equivalence, and in particular when the sequence of random measures Pn phi n tends in law to the random measure m, we have the convergence in law of phi prime n to gamma m. We wish to precise this result. It's complicated to, it's not possible to give this result for a stronger convergence, but we can precise the convergence speed of this convergence for convergence in law. So with as follows. We define a Polish distance, so the Polish distance d star between two measures nu1 and nu2 is given by the following sum, and we consider the Kantorovich-Rubinstein distance associated to this new distance. So the Polish distance replaces the total variation distance in the previous cases. And a good thing is that this Kantorovich-Rubinstein distance gives exactly a metric for the convergence in law for point processes, so we can precise the convergence of the last theorem, and it's the case because with the same assumptions than Kallenberg's theorem, we have control for the distance between phi prime n and the Cox process gamma m, which is given by this sum, which tends to zero as soon as Pn tends uniformly to zero, and Pn phi n, sequence Pn phi n, tends in law to the random measure m. So it was the third and last application. We can imagine other applications as soon as we find some sequences of point processes which converge to a Poisson point process or a Cox process. So thank you for your attention, and if you have any questions. The first situation. The first situation. Yes. Here. This yes. It is applicated in. The theoretical study is given only by the superposition. But after there is no link between the first motivation. Okay,
because it is a convergence.
Yes.
Yes.
Yes, and for a stronger distance,
yes.
Because we can show this result for.
Yes, the compensation is the distance is stronger.
Yes, yes.
But in some sense, this is not the same kind of theorem.
It's we can show the result easily for convergence in law if we consider Laplace transforms. We have this result without problem. but we don't have convergent speed because we don't have a distance, and this distance is quite strong, because total variation distance, for example, if we take total variation distance between two point processes which are infinite with a finite number of points, we can't have the convergence in the Kantorovich-Robertson distance.